Breakthrough assembler robotics can build almost anything, including planes, buildings, and even other robots. Researchers at MIT have made substantial progress toward developing robots that are practically and economically capable of assembling essentially anything, including objects that are much larger than themselves, such as larger robots, buildings, and cars. Though recent studies showing that structures like a deformable airplane wing or a working race car could be assembled from tiny, identical lightweight pieces are all part of the new work from MIT's Center for Bits and Atoms. The group has now demonstrated that the subunits that make up the assembler bots and the parts of the structure being created can all be the same. Large numbers of the robots can move autonomously and quickly complete complex assemblies. It could be years before there exists a completely autonomous self-replicating robot assembly system that is capable of planning the ideal construction sequence as well as assembling larger structures, including larger robots. However, the new research makes significant progress in that direction by figuring out difficult problems like when to produce more robots, how big to make them, and how to organize robot swarms of various sizes to construct a structure effectively without colliding with one another. The new method uses voxels, which are large structures made from an array of tiny, identical subunits. However, the team has now created complex voxels that each can transfer both power and data from one unit to the next, whereas prior voxels were just mechanical structural components. This could make it possible to build extremely complex structures that can lift, move, support loads, and manipulate materials, including the voxels themselves. The actual robots are made up of a string of many voxels linked end-to-end. These can migrate like inchworms to the appropriate spot, where they can grasp another voxel using attachment points on one end, connect it to the growing structure, and release it there. Once the size of the structure being built reaches a certain point in relation to the size of the assembler robot, the bots can determine that it's time to construct a larger version of themselves that can travel farther and do so with less effort, thanks to this new technology. As these robotic machines assemble anything, they are faced with decisions at each stage of the process, where they can either build a structure, a smaller robot, or a larger robot. The development of the algorithms for such decision-making is a current focus of work. Although the experimental system can assemble and has power in data links, the connectors between the tiny subunits in the current versions are too weak to support the necessary loads. The researchers are working on creating stronger connectors to enable the construction of a variety of large, complex, and valuable structures using these methods. Google's DeepMind creates artificial intelligence bots for interactive video games. DeepMind's new platform enables the creation of AI bots that can operate in unstructured situations and obey directions from humans. In order to start communicating with humans on their own terms, Google DeepMind has shown the initial steps in constructing video game AIs that can comprehend human notions. This paradigm creates agents that can talk, listen, ask questions, navigate, find and retrieve information, manipulate objects, and do a variety of other tasks in real time, despite the fact that it is still in its early phases. The framework in the world of video games begins with player interactions. Through imitation learning, DeepMind gave agents a broad but unrefined variety of actions. This behavior prior is crucial for enabling humans to assess the interactions. The behavior of the agent is further evaluated by humans, and these evaluations are optimized through reinforcement learning to produce better agents. As opposed to relying on the score in a game, the DeepMind researchers asked users to make assignments that the AI could use to assess its development. Through this approach, the DeepMind paradigm improves agent behavior using flexible and grounded human interaction. Three steps were taken to create the AI agents. They started by instructing the bots to emulate the foundations of simple human exchanges, including when one person requests something of another or offers an explanation. According to DeepMind's researchers, this involves creating a behavioral prior that enables agents to connect meaningfully with people. Without this imitation phase, the artificial intelligence agents just move and speak at random, making it difficult to engage with them in a meaningful way and even more difficult to provide them with feedback. After training the agents on human preferences, the researchers optimized the agents using a reinforcement learning algorithm. Once inside the simulator, the agents were given instructions on how to respond to inquiries and adhere to rules. In order to obtain the task rules and queries, they first employed the tasks and questions from the human dataset. They also trained the AI agents to replicate how people set tasks and pose questions, as seen in the video, which features a conversation between two agents. The blue was trained to follow instructions and ask questions, and the yellow was trained to do the opposite. With the help of the new architecture, DeepMind expects that one day artificial intelligence in video games will be able to comprehend and respond to our naturally conveyed meanings, rather than just following predefined behavioral patterns, enabling the development of commonplace digital and robotic assistants for human interaction. New non-invasive brain-computer interface device transmits information through optic nerve. The previous president of Neuralink, who left the business last year, now runs a competing brain startup with a total investment of $160 million. This month, Max Hodak, the co-founder and former president of Neuralink, came out of hiding with a brand new brain-computer interface company named Science Corp. Despite the seeming similarities between the two businesses, the new BCI startup may have a significant advantage over Musk's brain company. Science Corp's interface, in contrast to Neuralink, won't require users to drill holes into their own heads or the heads of unwilling test subjects. The science of photonics, which employs light conveyed through a patient's optic nerve to send information, is the foundation of the approach used by Science Corp's BCI device. Theoretically, this approach may lead to applications like those Neuralink is pursuing, such as curing patients with severe disabilities before eventually boosting human cognition and computing. According to Hodak, his business has already created a science eye prototype device that can restore vision to test rabbits. The device makes use of an implanted 2mm wide LED strip in the retina, which can process wirelessly transmitted information. Hodak claims he intends to start human testing in the upcoming years, but that timeframe might be more difficult to achieve. When Neuralink first launched in 2016, it immediately caught the attention of Silicon Valley venture capitalists and transhumanists alike. However, Neuralink has yet to receive FDA approval to test its device on humans. Instead, Neuralink's most significant scientific discoveries have come from testing on macaque monkeys, a method that some animal rights organizations claim is too cruel and unusual to continue. Hodak and Musk may have different approaches, but their final goals seem to be the same. Similar to Neuralink, Science Corp aims to use its brain-computer interface technology to help those with disabilities who are in need of it, with the goal of developing it to the point where it might be used to improve cognitive abilities. In the future, BCI technology could replace cell phones as the primary method by which humans interface with computers and the internet. It's also possible that this breakthrough for the upload and download speeds of human cognition could lead to the technological singularity and the fusion of humans and artificial intelligence.